All of us, by nature, are creators. As children, we invented worlds that have never existed. We asked questions, but over time, we are told to be practical, get a job, settle down, and achieve certain things by a certain age. We are told to conform, to fit in with the way the world is, to not hope for too much. Conformity slowly but surely pressures you into a life that does not feel like your own. So now is the time to reimagine your life, because everything is created twice, first in the mind, and then in reality. So if you are ready for this, I invite you now to join me to meet someone who will help you remember again your hopes and dreams. My name is Sarah from Unlock Your Life, and I will be your guide. Find a comfortable place to sit or lie down. Let go of all ego, expectations, and effort. Simply adopt an attitude of curiosity. With curiosity comes hope for something new, to dream of possibilities, to invent something that no one else has ever created. But for now, simply follow the journey, just as you would when turning a page of a book. And now that you're comfortable, when you are ready, you can close your eyes. Let the story unfold. And behind your closed eyes, I want you to imagine a scene, an everyday scene. This is a new place in your imagination, but the feelings are so very familiar. That daily routine, going to the same place every day. Notice what you feel. You see high-rise buildings on either side. You hear the busy footsteps, the hum of traffic. On either side of you, there are people walking up and down the street. Everyone with their heads down, looking at phones, looking at watches, or looking at nothing at all. Grey buildings, grey pavement, and even grey looking people. The streets are so busy, and you have a feeling that you are behind schedule. So you look around for a taxi, and as if by magic, one appears straight away and pulls up to the curb. The door opens and you hop in the back. Close the door, state your destination and sit back. Inside the cab, it has a safe and cozy feeling to it. You feel the taxi gently sway as it pulls away from the curb. You notice the digital display of the cab fare as the brightly lit numbers start to go up. You feel the rumble of the car, the sense of the wheels going round and round, the outside sounds are quieter, and the grey of the outside world fades more and more into the background. Now that you are moving forward, you feel more and more relaxed. It starts to rain lightly, and you hear the windscreen wipers start to move back and forth. Back and forth. The pitter-patter of rain dances on the glass, and each wipe of the blades clears the scene more, and you relax more into your seat as all outside sounds are quieter and quieter now. And you hear the rain above all else. It is a soft and soothing sound, light and relaxing. The traffic seems heavier, and the taxi moves slower than usual. You inch closer and closer to the traffic lights. Other than the bright lights of the cab fare and the traffic lights ahead, everything seems just a different shade of grey. The cab inches forward again. You partially wind down one window to see where you are. Grey buildings, grey wall, grey people. And you glance at the cab fare, and for some reason now, the numbers start to go down. It says 10. And the cents are cycling down quickly. 99, 98, 97. The traffic slowly moves forward, just a few inches. And the lights go from green to amber and red again. You glance at the display of the fare, and it is at 5 now. You blink, and it now says 4. Out the window, grey wall. 3, see the lights change from red to green. 2, and you feel calmer and calmer. 1, the lights stay green. But nothing moves. And you see something, some colour, out the corner of your eye. You look, and in the scene of grey, where you thought just a moment before there was just a grey stone wall, you now see brightly coloured vines and flowers, and a staircase leading down to an entrance. And for some reason you feel that this is your destination. And the cab door opens, and you step out. As you stand and stretch, you notice the quiet, the stillness. Everything is frozen in time. No movement. No sound. Even the rain has stopped. Pedestrians are mid-step. Birds are suspended mid-flight. And the traffic light is frozen, shining like an emerald jewel. A bright eye. Time itself seems to pause. And in that pause, that moment, everything in your life can change. And you continue to breathe. And you move forward now. You slip through the crowds of people with ease. And you find yourself at the top of the stairs that lead down into a small private courtyard. The bright colours of the flowers you see in this space fill your mind's eye with reds, purples, and gold. And they stand out against the grey of this everyday world. Their fragrances float up the staircase, and you inhale the perfume with satisfaction. You place a hand on the iron handrail and take the 5 steps down. And feel yourself almost as if you float your way down, and 5 and 4, sinking more and more into calm, 3, feeling that this is so right, 2, gliding, 1, floating down, and 0, arriving. You see an old wooden doorway to your left, and plant pots of flowers all around this small courtyard. Flowering vines line the stone walls, draped as delicately as a necklace around a lady's neck. The place seems refined and mysterious at the same time. Whoever owns this space takes care of every plant. There are a few smaller trees in pots too, and one in particular is just a thin sapling. You turn to the doorway now. The door is old, a bit weathered and worn, but solid, with a sense of curiosity. You reach for the brass handle and open the door. A bell above the doorway tinkles slightly, and you step inside. The place is dimly lit and emanates a sense of history, as if from a different place and time. You close the door behind you and pause. But hear no footsteps. As your eyes adjust to the inside space, you make out shelves filled with books and bottles. This seems like an old apothecary, a forgotten sanctuary. And every glass bottle seems to sparkle with a different light. Through the light and shadow, every corner is lit up with different colors, emanating from each one of the glass bottles and jars. And right in the very center is a magnificent old and tall tree. You take a step back again to appreciate the height as it soars so high. There is an opening in the center of the room, and the treetop extends further than you can see. Shelves are curved and wind around the thick and heavy branches. This place seems otherworldly, but familiar at the same time. It is no coincidence you are here. There is a reason you found this place, that you see this scene and hear these words. As you step forward into the room, you notice more. To your left is a long, heavy, solid wood countertop, and behind that, a back door. As you take a few steps forward and circle around the tree, you see there is a large stone fireplace on the far wall. And the flames are low, glowing and warm. In front of the fireplace is a heavy oak antique desk and a large leather-bound chair. A lamp on the desk shines a spotlight on the cover of a thick and heavy book. You take a moment to walk around the room, guided by your intuition. You feel at ease here and pick up some of the books and bottles. Perhaps you notice the titles of some of the books. Each book holds knowledge, waiting to be unlocked. And each bottle sparkles and shimmers as if they contain the essence of wishes and dreams. You pass in front of the fire, feel the warmth of the low flames, and you now face the heavy wood counter. And you see that the door behind the counter is open. A soft, inviting light shimmers through the doorway, inviting you to come forward. You step behind the counter and see through the doorway to a back room. As you approach, you see a figure with their back to you. They are talking softly and slowly as they lean over a large book that takes up most of the desk they stand in front. Though you have not seen their face, you hear a soft and patient voice. You see this figure is dressed in robes that shimmer with color when they move, as if the fabric itself was a source of power. You stand in the doorway, and they speak again, but this time to you. "Come in," they say. "I've been expecting you." They turn around, and you see a wrinkled face of a man who smiles as he looks over the top of his glasses at you. They have a calming energy and at the same time emanate a power. Their eyes twinkle as they smile in a way that seems as if they know you. He speaks again, at last. "I was hoping you would be here sooner." They nod their head a few times, as a parent would to a child. They see your expression change and reassure you. But now is always the right time. The fact you are here is good news. He puts down a glass bottle and carefully closes the book, marking his place with a bookmark. Then he opens his arms wide and states, "Welcome, seeker of dreams. You have entered a realm where dreams are made manifest, where intention and wisdom combined can transform the plain fabric of life into the material from which dreams become reality." You ask them, "Are you the alchemist?" He looks at you with a smile, hesitates, and then states, "Some call me by that name. Others say I am the guardian of dreams. I protect them. I store all your wisdom. I nurture all truthful intentions." He pauses and then says, "There is an alchemist here. This much is true." He smiles and says, "This will make sense soon. You start to ask a question, but with a graceful gesture, they usher you through the door into the main room and towards the heavy oak desk in front of the fire. They pull the chair out for you and open the book. The book seems to glow with an inner light. You may have been here before. Or this may be the very first time. Now, the guardian continues, you came here because you have a wish or a dream. Please take a seat. And you sit down in the comfortable old chair. But you came here too because you have doubts or questions. But I assure you that you have everything you need to manifest your dreams. Now, take a moment to connect with the deepest dreams and desires. Do not think with your mind or state what you believe can or cannot happen. Beliefs, thoughts, logic alone can convince the mind of anything. The moment when you think or believe and speak words, you may be speaking on behalf of everyone else but yourself. The moment when you listen and hear your soul's guidance, when you feel the truth within you, then you will know that your dreams are truly your own. You look at the low burning flames of the fire. And you can feel the light reflected in your own eyes. And the light of the wizardly figure. The guardian walks up to you and looks directly into your eyes. Their eyes contain the universe, and their voice echoes with a wisdom of many ages. And he says, now, take time to connect to your soul's guidance and be sure that what you are about to wish to manifest does not come from ego, but rather from the soul. He shrugs and spreads his arms, and electric blue light ripples from his shoulders to his fingertips as he carries on. If you wish for material riches, you will find, like many others who have wished the same, that you will never escape the feeling of lack. If you wish for fame, another choice of the ego, you can have that. You can be recognized. But you will be doomed to never truly be seen This, he gestures to the space around you, is a place that knows the truth within you, that knows when you speak from the truth in your soul or when you speak from ego. He places a hand on the huge book on the desk in front of you. He then pauses and turns to look into the fireplace and finishes by saying, I have said my part. Now you decide. What do you wish to manifest? The low flames sway in the fire. The tree itself appears to be leaning to listen, and the light from each glass bottle sends crackles and sparks into the air around you. You close your eyes and invite the voice of your soul to speak. Allow your soul to guide you, to reveal your deepest dreams. Allow your imagination to pull back the curtains. See, sense, or hear your soul speak. Breathe in and out. Now, as you open your eyes, turn to a blank page in the book in front of you. Let your imagination and inspiration flow as you channel your vision of a dream life onto the pages of your book of dreams. It can be written in words, drawn with your inner vision, Let your hands be guided by the truth in you. Take your time here. Now the guardian takes the book and reads over your dream, nods and talks softly but kindly under his breath. He finishes reviewing your wishes, then lifts an arm and declares an aha and gets to work. He moves swiftly around the room, first pulling two slim bottles from a high shelf and places them on the desk. The robes crackle with light with every movement he makes. His energy is joyful. And every bottle in the room glows with a brighter light. He asks you to take a large jar of brightly colored liquid from the other side of the room. He guides you with gestures until you touch the right one. He nods and declares yes, and you lift it up with both hands and place it on the desk. He brings forward two or three more bottles, each one a different shape or size, and glowing with bright colors inside. And he carefully measures drops from each of these bottles and jars into a metal chalice, a goblet. He then moves to a shelf of books and pauses and selects a book that he flicks through to a certain page. He now begins to speak an incantation in a low voice as he holds one hand up. And as he reaches the final page, he throws the contents of the cup into the fire. As the elixir mingles with the flames, the fire dances with new intensity. and the flames change from an orange glow to every shade of color, casting different light and shadow around the room. And now you see the guardian pick up the heavy book that contains your dreams and casts the book into the fire. The flames leap higher, and colors of the flames become a vivid violet. And in the brightest of light, the book hovers and glows even brighter, suspended in the air above the flames. You see the fireplace expand and arch overhead as the dimensions of time and space begin to shift, and you are drawn forward into a portal. You see the guardian, the tree, the room, further and further behind. As you advance at a pace through a long arching tunnel, and as you see the arch pass overhead, you see the end of the tunnel. Another flash of light. And as the light slowly dims again, you see you are in the world of your dreams, manifested in reality. Notice how you feel here. Look around. What do you notice about your dream life made reality? Notice every detail here. Take a minute here. Breathe in and out. And now you feel yourself being drawn backwards. You see the future life as an island in the cosmos. And the time tunnel draws you back and back. And slowly but surely, you see the future life getting further and further away, with a chasm of time and space ever increasing between you and your dreamer. So you blink. And you find you are now back in the room. And the fireplace burns a warm amber glow again. As you blink and orient yourself in the room, you see that the book is suspended above the fire. Before you can speak, the alchemist retrieves it from the fire. Both he and the book are unscathed, untouched by the flames. He opens the book to the page that you wrote, and then turns the page. There is a new message, which radiates with clarity and inspiration. The guardian sees the new message. Perhaps it is an answer to a question or a doubt. He conveys this message to you in a way that only you can understand. Notice what information you receive here. Once you have received the message, he seems to know what you will say next. The guardian says, "How do you know what I say to you is true?" Because the truth will only speak to the truth already contained in you. In fact, all that I say are not my words, but your own. I do not sow any seeds in your mind, but rather I water the seeds of the dreams, already taking root in your soul. Remember, he says, pointing at the book, you now have a record of your dreams. And you can add to this whenever you come back here. And when you are ready, I will have more wisdom and guidance for you. I am always here for you. And you wonder why you are shown the future land and life of your dreams, only to be taken away again. And as he sees you thinking this over, he answers, the dream life you seek is not a destination or place, and the greatest changes you need to make begin with your inner world. And you will see how your outside world will change too. And now that you have spent time hearing the wisdom of the guardian, they lift up the heavy book and remind you that they will continue to protect your book of wishes and dreams. They now guide you to the door. Open it. The bell above the door rings in the same way again. But between then and now, so much has changed. As you stand in the doorway, the guardian speaks. Your dreams are now woven into the very fabric of the universe. And even as you leave this place, you are not leaving your dreams behind. You carry your dreams with you, for they are now part of you. And as you glance outside, you may feel a mix of emotions. You see the bright lights inside the apothecary, the warm fireplace, the glow from every glass bottle, the crackle of lights that ripple along the alchemist's robes, and the very light in his eyes. And you turn to look at the grey world outside. And they see your hesitation, your doubt, and say, you can transcend the greyness, the mediocrity of everyday life. You are the light. You step outside. The door closes. And you hear the gentle tinkling of the bell again. You notice the thin sapling again in a small pot, just a few leaves. And you remember the words of the alchemist again. Even though there is no visible change in your outside world just yet, your inside world is already changing. just as no one can see the roots going deeper, or an extra ring growing under the bark of this thin and spindly sapling. One day it will become a magnificent tall tree. And every day, in some way, you will continue to nourish your dreams. And as you look at the grey world beyond the staircase, you commit to mind the experience of this time. You know that you carry the power to manifest your dreams. And you walk up the steps and stand at the top until life slowly returns from stillness to movement again. Traffic lights blink. People move forward blindly to the place they always go. And birds soar in the sky. You look at the route that you usually take, and you now decide to walk away from the everyday path. Away from that well-worn path that you have walked along so many times, over so many days and years. You start to walk in a new direction, and you feel that you are walking against the flow of the masses of people. And at some point you hesitate and pause. The world is so large, so vast, so endlessly grey. And you look back one more time and can only see a high stone wall where the staircase used to be. For a moment you may feel that you stand at a crossroads between dream and reality. But a breeze blows, and in them are the final words of the guardian who whispers. And despite the rumble of the traffic, the frantic footsteps around you, the words resonate clearly. When all the lights and shadow of today dissolve, when my words have become echoes, even when memories have faded from the mind and become half forgotten, the soul always remembers. It is not I, the creator of your dreams. You are the true alchemist. With these words, you smile and continue to walk the new path, walking against the flow of conformity, walking the path that will lead to manifesting your dreams. In every step you take, in every choice you make, is an opportunity to bring your dreams to life, just as every insignificant drop of water nourishes a sapling which will eventually grow into a magnificent old tree. And if you ever feel that you need guidance again, or simply need encouragement and reassurance, you can seek out this sanctuary at any time to build courage and find the next steps forward. Thank you for joining me on this journey today. My name is Sarah from Unlock Your Life, and as always, I am here to support you.